Hey guys, it's Vignesh from Code Android. In this video, we'll see about button and its type. To demonstrate this, I already created an empty Flutter project. In this, added center as the body for the scaffold and added column as its child. I want the column to wrap its children height, so setting main axis size as main axis dot min. To know more about row and column, please watch this video. Let's add a button. For the first type, I'm choosing raised button. For the buttons, we need to pass a mandatory field called onPressed. This is a callback which will be triggered on click of the button. Here, I'm printing raised button. When we save the code, we are able to see the basic button. To change the color of the button, we need to use color attribute. To add some content like text, icon or other widgets, we can use child attribute. Here I'm adding click me text. As our button color is dark, changing the text color to white using style attribute. You can see on click of the button, onPressed is executed. Due to that, it's printing raised button in the console. In some cases, we might want the button to have rounded corner. To do that, we need to add shape to the button. For the shape, passing rounded rectangle border, inside setting the border radius as border radius dot all with circular radius as 30. You can see our button got rounded corner. I want more space between the text and the button. To adjust that, we need to use padding attribute. Here, I'm using symmetric edge inset and passing vertical as 8 and horizontal as 30. You can see we have more space on the left and right side of the text. In some scenarios, we might need to set constant width and height for the button. To do that, we need to wrap the button using sized box or container. Here, I'm wrapping the button using sized box and setting width as 300 and height as 100. You can see the button width and height got overridden. But the button is looking too big, so changing width as 200 and height as 50. I want some gap between buttons, so adding sized box with height as 16. We have all these attributes to customize all the type of buttons. Now we'll see about button types available in Flutter. Flat button is used to add button without any elevation. Here also printing the button name in onPressed. If we see here, child is accepting widget, so this time we'll pass the icon as child. So passing icon of icons.add. You can see we got the button, but it's looking too simple, so changing the background color to orange using color attribute. The next type is outline button. As the name suggests, it will have only outline for the button. Here also adding the child as click me. Sorry, the background color is white, so the text is not visible. To fix that, removing the style attribute. For the floating action button, we have a dedicated widget called floating action button, which is suitable for displaying single menu item with the icon. In this widget, the icon color will be taken automatically according to our theme. If needed, we can override it. Also, we have a dedicated place for fab button inside the scaffold. If we add the floating action button here, we get the button at the bottom right of the scaffold. We have an extended version of the fab button where we can add some label to it. Here, we don't have child attribute, instead we need to use icon. You can see we are getting an error because label is mandatory for the extended version. So adding label as click me. You can see we got the fab with label. Now, we have seen the most common button styles. What if we want our button to have gradient color? There is no attribute called gradient for button. To do that, we need to do some trick here. To get that, we can use raised button and passing the container as its child. Now, setting the gradient to the container using decoration. You can see when I save the code, we are not able to see the gradient, but we are seeing only the button. This is happening due to min height constraint of the button itself. Also, our container doesn't have any child. So, adding click me text as the child for the container. You can see we got the button, but the gradient is not covering entire button. Now, we need to remove the padding of the button. To do that, setting padding as edgeinsert.0 and adding padding to our container. You can see we got our gradient button. The button text is not visible properly, so changing the color using textile. To make this button as rounded, adding shape to the button as well as border radius to the decoration. Otherwise, we will get the button background like this. We can achieve the same by using the shape as stadium border. As the name suggests, stadium border will add the background like stadium. To use the stadium border in container, we need to use shape decoration instead of box decoration. For the shape decoration, we can pass the shape as stadium border. You can see there is no change in the result. Now, we'll see how to create outline button with gradient. We can't set gradient to the outline border directly, so I found a class to do this. So, adding this gradient outline button, inside we need to pass 5 mandatory fields. So, I'm passing child as click me text, gradient as linear gradient with blue to green, empty onPressed callback, stroke as 4 and radius as 16. You can see we got the button with gradient outline. Like this, we can customize our button according to our UI needs. That's all for this video, guys. If you have any doubt, please put it in the comment section. I will try to answer it. Hope you like it. I will see you in my next video. Have a nice day.